The headlines, so home buyers remain cautious and subdued housing market. Despite what you've seen with the OCR, they're still a little bit cautious about the market.
Kia ora everyone, it's Sam and Chris from the Bayleys Insights team. This week we are doing our weekly news video. So what have we got up first, Chris?
Yeah, mate. So first up, we got Reserve Bank did a bit of an update on the housing market. So this was part of their financial stability report. Basically, the gist of what they're talking about is that they believe home buyers will remain a little bit more cautious than you might perceived from some of the media coverage, mainly because house prices are still relatively high, interest rates are still relatively high, and some of the economic risks coming through. So yeah, just a bit of an interesting one. I guess their headlines, so home buyers remain cautious and subdued housing market. Despite what you've seen with the OCR, they're still a little bit cautious about the market. So there's the res. Sam, what about in commercial?
Yeah, so in commercial news, the government is going to review some of the rules around retirement villages.
Yep.
So just updating that Retirement Village Act to bring it in line with best practice, strengthening some of the transparency and increasing protection for residents.
Yep.
So yeah, good news for that space. And I guess the significance of that is that we have an aging population, and right now there's about 53,000 who currently live in retirement villages.
It's a really large number, right?
Yeah, and by 2048, demand will be estimated around 113,000. So pretty significant numbers, and
Got to protect all the elderly people out there, right?
Yeah,
so that sounds cool.
Cool, so next up we've got our sales snapshot. So what's the theme this week, Chris?
Yeah, mate, so a nice little theme, we were debating it yesterday. So poolside picks,
cool.
We've got one in Queenstown, one in Green Lane.
Awesome.
Yeah, do you want to maybe kick us off, Sam?
Yeah, so the one in Green Lane is 18 Matai Road. Breathtakingly reimagined, four bedroom, three bathroom on about 1200 square metres. The perfect synergy of character and modernity, heated pool and spa, and exceptionally landscaped gardens.
It's a cool house.
Yeah, really cool. This one was marketed by Jack Davies, Brittany Broadbent, and Glenn Baker from Bayleys One Tree Hill, and sold under the hammer for $4.4 million.
Yeah, it's a big price, eh? And I like the photography there, nice use of the pool and the photos.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah, and then so for me, I've got one down in Hanley's Farm in Queenstown, so 37 Barn Road. Headline auction brought forward, three beds, three baths on 510 square metres. Modern design, high-end features, views of the Remarkables Coronet Peak. Beautiful outdoor area featuring a covered pergola, kitchen and spa pools that ticks our poolside picks. Marketed by Cheryl Williams from Bayleys Frankton, Nick Newman from Bayleys Aratan, sold under the hammer for $1.5 million. So yeah, cool little snapshot.
Yeah, really cool. So we've got some international news out of New South Wales, Australia.
So interesting over there, right? They've just put through a bunch of residential tenancy amendments. And so very similar to what happened in New Zealand maybe a couple of years ago with things like addressing rent increases, payment rules, more pet-friendly policies. And the other one that they did, which is very similar to what was unwound in New Zealand, was they've introduced a ban on no-cause evictions. So kind of interesting to see them doing over there what we had done in New Zealand and have since unwound.
Similar stuff to just kind of balance that dynamic between tenant and landlord.
And cool as well to see more pet friendly policies coming through. I think that's really exciting and just kind of cool.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Cool, and to wrap up, we've of course got our property of the week. So what have you got in Auckland?
Yeah, mate, so pretty cool one. I've got 21-23-25 Paratai Drive in Oraki. So exceptional on Paratai, rare development site, 3,300 square metres across three titles, short walk down to the beaches, located about 5 kilometres from Auckland CBD in the downtown area. If you want to learn more about this one, contact Gavin Lloyd or Susie Wigglesworth from Bayleys Auckland Central.
Cool, yeah, and in Northland, I've got 50 Dolphin Place in Tutukaka, Whangarei. Catch of the day, it's a four bedroom, two bathroom property on 1.3 hectares, architectural masterpiece perched above the secluded Turquoise Bay.
Nice.
There's a really nice outdoor living area with the infinity mineral pool, carrying on with that pool theme, and a really cool pizza oven as well. So if you're interested in this one, you can get in touch with Sally Jordan from Bayleys Whangarei. Yeah, so nice little selection of properties there. With that being said, I guess we'll wrap up the rest of our video. So thanks, Chris.
Thanks, Sam.
Yeah, and we'll see you guys next week.
See ya.